हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट नाउ आई एम हियर इन ज्ञान निकेतन टीचिंग हिस्ट्री एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द फ्रांस एंड इन दिस चैप्टर यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन. बिफोर गोइंग टू द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन इन द चैप्टर वी मस्ट नो व्हाई द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन अकर्ड इन द फ्रांस. फ्रांस वॉज द वेल्थियस्ट कंट्री and many immense power that they were having it, and they were having the many colonies also, and though the revolution took place in the France, but the revolution is having the some good impacts, some bad impacts also. The France revolution led to the growth of the idea of liberty, equality and fraternity. The idea also inspired the some of the different other territory of the European countries to form the government in a democratic way. These ideas also led the launching of the independence movement in the country, such as in India, China, Africa, and many other different Latin America also launched the movement, national movement. In the year of 1789, in the France Revolution started, and leading to the series of the events that took place by the middle class of the peoples in the France. As well as we must know that the people revolt against the cruel dynasties, cruel monarchies in the France. Now why they do so? Why they revolted against the France monarchy? What is the reason behind it? So going through the causes, first of all, we must know about the society of the France. Now, the France society was divided into the state. What do you mean by the state? A state is a degree of the quality or the people that are defined, the quality of the people that they are having it. That is known as a state. So, France society was divided into the three states. Number one state, they are clergy. Second state, they are nobility. Third state, they are the common. Now, who were the clergy? Clergy, they belongs to the first state. Clergy, maximum the church. The people of the church, bishop, archbishop, abbots are the part and parcel of the clergy. They were having the means, they were very much wealthy, they were also collecting the tax, and the tax that was collected by the clergy that was known as a tithe. So tithe is a type of a tax which was collected by the church, and they were also sometimes they were also forgiving the people, those who were persecuted, by giving the certificates. So such type of the immense life and the wealthiest life they were living. They were also collecting the tax as well as in the form of the food grains, in the form of the currency and many others. Now second state that we are having the nobility. Nobles, those who were from the birth, they were having the power. They were ruling, they were administrating the country, and they were exempted from paying the different types of the tax that the other common people were having it. So the nobles were further given the feudal privileges. They were collecting the feudal dues. They were very much powerful in the France. Only the 80,000 peoples were those who belonged to the nobles, and they got a lot of power to govern the country, to collect the taxes as well as the privilege that they were having from the birth only. So these are the some of the categories of the people, those were known as the nobilities. Now we are coming to, the third state, which is being known as a common. In a common categories, there are number of the peoples are there. Three categories of the peoples were defined. Categories of the peoples are there in the third common. where first is the big businessman, merchants, court officials were there. Those who were having the right of education, those who can learn, those who can teach, and many different types of the work, they can do it. But the second categories were there, that was a very small piece in it. Farmers, artisans, those who are not having the right of education, they can't learn, and they have to be under the pressure of the nobles as well as the clergy. They have to pay the different types of their taxes. They were suppressed, they were crushed, they were have to adapt the rules and regulation that has been defined by the monarchy, as well as the they were having the control under the leadership of the nobles and the church. They had to pay the different types of tax, such as the tithe I told you, that was collected by the church, as well as the tallies, that was a direct tax that was collected by the state of the France. So this is the society of the state that has been defined in the France, which is, can we can call it the major cause of the France Revolution. Thank you.